So again, what makes this machine different is, number one, the size of the mannequins is basically 2.5 times the size of any other mannequin you'll find in any other arcade sports-related game. Number two, the size of the machine is very interesting in terms of the scale of it. It's just tape over this cast ashtray there. You have these big turned, cast aluminum turnbuckles. You have the bungee rope. You have the canvas-covered platform. It feels like you're at the center of a real boxing ring. So number one, it's the scale of it. Number two, it's the furniture presentation of the cabinet and the scale of the machine itself. Number three, you're head-to-head, end-to-end. Always the best way to play a two-player game when you're looking at your opponent on the other side. And then number four, it's the whole size of the machine, fluidity of the mechanism. So this pure mechanical mechanism will never break, it's just not going to break down like an electronic machine. It's not going to need service. Your ability to control everything, the manual aspect of the one-to-one ratio between turning a knob down here and turning a fist down there. If I crank down slowly, the fist comes up slowly. On the other hand, if I give it a real good turn, up comes a fairly violent punch. You're all protected in here in terms of rubber. These rubber wheels collide. It's just a very well-engineered, head-to-head competitive arcade machine. One of my favorite mannequin games of all time, one of the best finds I ever had in terms of finding these machines in South America and bringing them back and having them restored.